Hello, hello, my ladies. How is everyone doing? It is Diamond Debbie's Gloss and Glow coming at y'all with the good, the bad, and the ugly. Okay? So, I've got my glamourless hand ready. I love her so much. Now, what we're going to be doing today is going to be the dip powder. And the system I'm going to be using is, I have the Kiara Scott Natural. I don't think I'm going to use this. I'm not. I'm just going to use some colors. Normally, I would put the Natural down as a base, and then I would put it on top for filing. But with this, since it's not a real client and real nails, I'm not, because these are pretty opaque. Okay, these nails are natural of this color, okay? And so I don't need to put this base, but if you're doing a client, by all means, put your natural base on, okay? I'm using the Kiara Sky Dip Liquid System, but I'm using the Revel powders, okay? So yes, you can mix and match them if that's your next question. Yes, you can, absolutely. I bought a lot of these Revel, and this is what I started with, and I loved them. I have got so many beautiful colors, but the thing is, I could not make their liquids work for me. I'm not saying they're not good. I'm just letting y'all know I couldn't get them to function, and I went through 4 sets that they sent me with the liquids hardening up from one of the other ones, you know, after you use it, and then you put another, you know, use it over something, it would harden. I don't know why. So, the Kiara Sky has treated me well. The liquids work perfect, and so that is what I'm doing. I do have a couple of Kiara Skies, and I will be probably turning over to that, but the Revel, you can earn points and get free powders, and also, like I said, excellent customer service. They gave me 4 free liquid sets, the complete $40 sets, ladies. So, I have nothing bad to say. Other than I couldn't get the liquids to work. Now, let's get on with what we're doing here. I don't want to take a lot of y'all's time. What I did so far is I buffed these and I put this gelish pH bond. Okay? So that's what I've done so far, and that's it. You're going to shake your powders up, get them prepared, and we are using the Revel D167 Phoebe, which is a beautiful pink. It's a pale pink. And then we're going to be using the beautiful D20 Erica. Oh, actually, I've got these messed up, you guys. I put the wrong lid on. The Erica, the D20 Erica is the light pink. And then the D167 Phoebe is this beautiful diamond. Oh, beautiful. Okay, so that's what we're going to do. And let's get started. Okay, the first thing you're going to do is use your base, your bond of your Kiara Sky, okay? So that's what we're going to do first. We're going to put a little bit of bond on each one. And if you had a client, of course you would have already prepped their cuticles and pushed them back and took the shine off of their nails as well. That's what I did on this one. I just took the shine off of these nails, okay? And now I dehydrated them with that gelish pH bond, and now I'm using the Kiara Sky bond that goes with the set, and that's number one, okay? Then what you're going to do, ladies, is take your number two, and this is your base, okay? The base of everything. So what you're going to do is take this base. Wow, alrighty then. Like, did I do that? Ah, I got it. My goodness, ladies, I about thought I glued it shut. So you're going to take your Kiara Sky number 2 base, okay? And I'm going to try to keep this out of the way and keep y'all in view. I'm sorry, but this is the best that I can do. And y'all watch me work, okay? So this is going to be the base, and we're going to do 2 nails at a time if we can. That's what I prefer to do, so that, like I said, I don't take much of y'all's time. So you put your base, a thin little coat will do, and then you dip, okay? So we're going to dip it into the pink, the pinky, all right? 1, 2, okay? Then go over here, because I want this ring finger to be my accent nail, okay? So that is going to be the silver, the diamonds, okay? The Phoebe. All right, then the other two we're going to do in the pale pink. And I'm babying this hand because this is my new glamourless practice hand, as y'all know. And I just do not want to, for nothing, mess this beautiful thing up. I know it's meant to do this with, but ladies, I'm telling you, I just don't want to mess it up. Okay, so y'all can see this. This is what you do. Dip it in, dip your powder, and then you're going to take a brush. Any kind of brush will do. I've got this one here I'm using, and you're going to brush this little top part off. Okay, just brush it off lightly. Okay, get a little bit of this off the hand, see, just like that. Okay, then you're going to do a number two coat, okay? I'm going to raise this just a dad, okay, thank you. Now you're going to do your number two base. You're going to do base again, so on all nails, okay? So we're going to put a base on this one, the pinky, and the base back onto the glitter nail. And we're going to dip it again, okay? So let's do that. So here we go. I'm going to do it this way for y'all, okay? So there's your pink. Alrighty. Beautiful. And here is your diamond. I got a little bit of pink in here. I better watch what I'm doing, huh? Right, ladies. Y'all got to get on to Diamond Debbie. Okay, this little pinky finger, I'm going to be removing that ring before too long because it just keeps wanting to come off on me. I don't know why, but it does, okay? So, then you're going to go ahead and do your other two fingers the same way. Such a beautiful set of nails. I love this look, okay? So, dip that one, dip, and dip this one, okay? Now, after you've done all your nails and your dip powders, and like I said, normally if this was a client, you would be doing this a little bit different in that you would put a little more, you put your natural base, like I said, and then on top of that, you would add a base over these, okay? So I'm done with the dip. That's about it for that. And check them out, how beautiful they turned out, ladies. They're lovely. Okay, so let me put this up real quick. Let me get it right this time. This one's the Erica, the pink, okay? And then I have my Phoebe in the diamonds, which is just beautiful, I tell you. All right, so now I usually put a base, and I think I'm not going to do that this time. Well, actually, I don't know. I might on this. Depends how it feels. It feels a little sticky for some reason. That one does. I don't know why. So let me put it back in just a little bit. I'm thinking that something ain't right with that. Just quickly, ladies. Sorry about that. But I don't think I got it far enough down because I felt a little bit of the base, okay? Then you just brush, like I said. Just brush it off, okay? There you have it. So there is your beautiful dip nails. And you see the Kiara Sky and the Rebel powder works very well together, okay? Now, what you're going to do next is you can either put another coat on top of the clear, and this is mainly for filing and buffing purposes, okay? You do not want to have to buff the color off of your client, so you would put a clear. But since this is not a client and I'm not trying to take a whole lot of y'all's time on this video, I am not going to do this step. This you would put as the base, you would do two coats of your colors, and then you would do this as a top coat, okay, until you get, and you would seal it with the top coat of clear. And that way you can file and shape, and you would use your cuticle bit and go around their cuticles as well as a sanding band, a sand over them, and bam, you've got a beautiful set of nails, ladies, okay? So let me go on in. Let me get into step three. This is your seal and protect, all right? So that's the other step. After you put your natural on top, that's what you would be doing. So right now, and this is what really makes this stuff harden up, is your seal and protect. So don't be greedy with it, is all I can say, because this is the stuff that makes it work, okay? This is what's going to make it hard and make it an enhancement for you on your client and make it last them 3 weeks, okay? And dip powder absolutely can last 3 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks, depending on your client's nail growth. But I used to get the dip powders when the SNS first come out, which was like 5 years ago, believe it or not. And there was only one person even doing them. And I tell you what, ladies, it was amazing. And they did last me 3 weeks, but my nails grow a little slow. So that was your Seal and Protect, okay? Now, after you put your Seal and Protect on, this gives you the opportunity, now's your time to file. If it's your client, you're going to file their nails now, okay? If you see anything you want to get off, you're going to file. You see a little bit coming off the ends, okay? Which you would put it on the tip of the nail and seal that in if it's the client also. I'm sure y'all know this, okay? But I'm letting you know in case it's a beginner out there that doesn't know. Then you're going to take your buffer and you're going to buff them because this is what's going to make that slick, slick, smooth surface that we're looking for in all of our nail enhancements, okay? In fact, let me do it this way for y'all so y'all can see better. There you go. I'm not right-handed, but I am especially doing it for y'all. So here's how you would do it. You would buff lightly. You don't want to buff hard. You don't want to take it off. And that's why I said, normally I would put that clear coat over the top. I would not put it on my glitters though. Do not put it on your glitter. Because I've noticed if you put that, it takes it away. Okay? Just so you know, it'll take it away. But this is all you would do. And you'd go around it with a cuticle bit, like I said, just to, you know, really make it work. So there you have it, ladies. That's how you do it. And then let's brush these off one more time because of buffing. You don't want no stuff on your nails. And then what you're going to do is you're going to put this Seal and Protect, your second coat of Seal and Protect. These rings are giving me a fit like this one. I'm going to have to take off, I think. Anyway, so you take your Seal and Protect and I'm getting there, ladies. Bear with me. Alright, Seal and Protect. Do it one more time, okay? Because this is going to make your top coat for Kiara Sky really pop. If you don't have to do this step, your top coat will not be alright. Just letting you know, it will not be alright, okay? So y'all see what I'm doing. I'm in the camera. Okay, there you go. So that's that. And like I said, don't be stingy with it. Put it on it. It ain't going to hurt it. Alright, then you're done with that. Now what you want to do is take a lint-free wipe. Okay, I have these beautiful pink ones that I bought off of eBay or Amazon. And you're going to rub it in. So you're just going to rub this Seal and Protect in to your nails. Okay, just rub it in. And maybe this is why this does not harden when I do it. Because it was normally, I don't know, the Revel, like I said, liquids just gave me a really hard time. I don't know why. Maybe someone can enlighten me that's got experience with that product. Okay, now you're going to do your Kiara Sky Step 4 Top Coat. Okay, and let's see. You're going to do two of these, okay? And you're going to do them very quick, and you're not going to do a lot. You're going to do it quick and kind of sparse, it says, on your first one. On your first top coat, okay? You're really supposed to just go 1, 2, 3. But y'all, I overindulge a little bit. Sorry about that, but that's just my habits. Okay, there we go. And look at there, ladies. Oh, my goodness, have you ever... All right, and I'm going to do a shot of these, and I will post it before the video, a still shot, a glamour shot, so that y'all can check it out and see what you think. But you will apply one more coat of your top coat to these, and you have got a set of nail enhancements. Then, ladies, if you want to, you can put some Swarovski crystals, you can do some rhinestones, you can do whatever you want with these, okay, to enhance them. Like I said, I'm just trying not to take much of y'all's time on this, but this is the first of the series of the good and the bad and the ugly, ladies. So I'm excited, I'm pumped. Tell me what y'all think in the comments below. And as always, lady, Y'all, please subscribe, like, and share. And I want y'all to know I love y'all. I could not be here without y'all, ladies. Y'all are amazing. And I'm going to have some things coming up, so y'all stay tuned. But for now, whoop, we got to go. See you later.